The slope is the measure of the inclination or the steepness of a line. Slope is derived from the Latin root slopan, for slip. The term somehow connotes the level or ground slipping away as you go forward. M is used to represent the slope of a line. It is not known why the letter M was chosen for slope. The choice may have been arbitrary. John Conway has suggested that M could stand for modulus of slope. It is interesting that the French word for to climb is monter. However, there is no evidence to make any such connection. René Descartes, who was French, did not use M.
These are the formulas for slope. M equals vertical change over horizontal change. It also can be read as change in y over change in x, the same with here. And this formula used to find the slope if the given is 2 points. And if the given is the graph, we can use M equals rise over run. Note that an upward or rightward motion or a line is rising from left to right, it represented a positive value for slope. And if the line is falling from left to right, it represented a negative value for slope. For examples, given the graph, determine the slope of this line. To find the slope of a line, given the graph, use the formula rise over run. Choose any 2 points on the line and I will use these 2 points. Apply the formula rise over run from this point. Count the units it rises. 1, 2, 3. So this point rises 3 units going to the second point. From here, count the units it runs. 1, 2, 3. Therefore, it runs 3 units going to the second point. The slope now is equal to 3 over 3 and the simplest form is 1. Observe that the line is rising from left to right. Therefore, the sign of the slope is positive. And the final answer, the slope is equal to positive 1. Example number 2. I will use these 2 points. From this most downward point, it rises 6 units and runs 2 units going to the second point. Simplify, 6 over 2 equals 3. Observe that the graph is falling from left to right. It represents a negative slope. Therefore, the slope is equal to negative 3. This is how to determine the slope of a line given its graph. If the given problem is the equation of the line, to find the slope, the equation must be written in slope-intercept form y equals mx plus b because m in the form represents the slope. Otherwise, rewrite the equation to its slope-intercept form. Example number 1. Y equals 2x plus 3. Observe that this equation is already in slope-intercept form. And if you just follow the form, slope is the numerical coefficient of x. Therefore, the slope is equal to positive 2.
Example number 2. Y equals negative 2/3 x plus 4. This equation is already in slope-intercept form. Therefore, the value of m or the slope is equal to negative 2/3.
Example number 3. X minus 2y equals negative 4. Observe that this equation is in standard form. Rewrite it to slope-intercept form. It will become y equals negative 1/2 x plus 2. How did it happen? Watch this tutorial video, rewriting linear equation from standard form to slope-intercept form and vice versa.
Going back, y equals negative 1/2 x plus 2, the slope is equal to negative 1/2.
This is how to determine the slope given the equation of the line. Finally, if the given are 2 points, use this formula. The slope is equal to y sub 2 minus y sub 1 over x sub 2 minus x sub 1. How to use this formula?
Example number 1, 12, negative 7 and 9, 2. The first point is 12 and negative 7. We'll mark this as x sub 1 and y sub 1. 9, 2 is the second point, so we'll mark this as x sub 2, y sub 2. Now, copy the formula. Substitute the values. Y sub 2 is equal to 2. Palitan natin si y sub 2 ng 2. Minus y sub 1 is equal to negative 7. Over x sub 2 is equal to 9. Minus x sub 1 is equal to 12. Simplify, 2 minus negative 7 is positive 9 over 9 minus 12 is negative 3. And 9 divided by negative 3 equals negative 3. The slope is equal to negative 3. Example number 2. Negative 2, negative 2, and 2, 1. The first point is negative 2, negative 2. So, we'll mark this as x sub 1 and y sub 1. The second point is 2, 1. We'll mark this as x sub 2 and y sub 2. Copy the formula. Next step is substitution. Y sub 2 is equal to 1. Minus y sub 1 is equal to negative 2 over x sub 2 is equal to positive 2 minus x sub 1 is equal to negative 2. Simplify, 1 minus negative 2 is positive 3 over 2 minus negative 2 is positive 4. The slope is equal to 3/4. Example number 3. 4, negative 3 and 4, 5. The first point is 4, negative 3. Mark this as x sub 1, y sub 1. The second point is 4, 5. Mark this as x sub 2 and y sub 2. Copy the formula. Next is substitution. The value of y sub 2 is 5 minus the value of y sub 1 is negative 3 over the value of x sub 2 is 4 minus the value of x sub 1 is 4. Simplify, 5 minus negative 3 is positive 8 over 4 minus 4 is 0. If the denominator is 0, its value is undefined. This is the final answer. And this is how to determine the slope of a line given 2 points.
To summarize this tutorial video, if the slope is positive, the orientation of the line is rising. If the slope is negative, the orientation is a falling line. And if the slope is 0, the line is horizontal. And if the slope is undefined, the line is vertical. Another, if the given is the graph, to identify the slope, use rise over run. Just choose any 2 points on the line. If the given is any 2 points on the line, use the slope formula. M equals y sub 2 minus y sub 1 over x sub 2 minus x sub 1. And lastly, if the given is the equation of the line, make sure that the equation is in slope-intercept form. This is your assignment. See your enrichment activities. MELC Q1 number 9. Activity 1, slope time.